Jameis Winston, number one overall pick in the 2015 draft, after five seasons with the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, says farewell after the Buccaneers signed Tom Brady. Peter King reports in Football Morning in America, Chris, that the Buccaneers' priorities entering free agency were Tom Brady 1, Teddy Bridgewater 2, Jameis Winston 3. So if they had not gotten Tommy or Teddy, they would have continued their relationship with Jameis Winston.
Well, the thing I'm surprised there more than anything is the Teddy Bridgewater angle. To me, again, no disrespect to Teddy Bridgewater, it just doesn't seem like a fit in the Bruce Arians, Byron Leftwich offense. Now, maybe that's like overcompensation for like, oh my gosh, Jameis Winston, a year with him and 30 interceptions. We'd rather go with a guy that we know is going to throw no interception. But Teddy Bridgewater, traditionally, not a downfield thrower, not aggressive that way. You know, in my opinion, has a little reputation of being Charlie Checkdown. But either way, I think that staff was scarred by what they saw from Jameis Winston the last few weeks of the year, and I understand it.
Well, and I also think that at this point, after dealing with Winston last year, Bruce Arians would rather coax a little no risk it, no biscuit out of Bridgewater than to have to reel in Winston,
right,
who's just throwing the ball everywhere, right?
Right. Yeah, I think that's totally fair. I think you're exactly right. I think he looked at it like, man, I don't think I can get Jameis Winston to ever play conservative or stop those plays where, you know, it's just you go, oh, it's over, abort mission, throw the ball away, and then he throws a ball into quadruple coverage. Teddy Bridgewater does not have that problem. You know, the thing I always say about Teddy Bridgewater, he may not win you games, but he's not going to lose you games either. And, yeah, a guy like Bruce Arians, he probably did feel like he could coax a little bit more of an aggressive mentality out of Bridgewater.
Hey, and Arians' defense saw Bridgewater in one of his five starts last year. He completed 76.5% of his passes, 314 yards, 9.2 yards per attempt, passer rating of 131.2. That may have had something to do with it. Talking to Todd Bowles, the defensive coordinator, about Teddy Bridgewater, maybe they saw something that they could build on. But obviously he's going to be with the Panthers. Winston is available. What's his landing spot now, Chris?
I mean, Mike, you tell me. I mean, what's it going to go? Where's it going to go? If I'm Jameis Winston right now, you're going down Teddy Bridgewater Lane, in my opinion. You're looking at forget how much money I'm going to make. What is the best way to resurrect my career? And what team gives me the best opportunity where if I'm a backup, I can go out in the field and succeed and show everybody that I've righted some of my wrongs about my game, and, you know, redo the perception of him out there. So that's why I've been saying, like, the Pittsburgh Steelers. To me, that would be a great spot. I know you think Ben Roethlisberger won't necessarily like that, but, again, Ben's only going to be around for a few more years. They got to start thinking for the greater good of the team. That's one team that jumps out to me right away, Mike. Kansas City Chiefs, hey, if you Patrick Mahomes gets hurt and you still want to run that offense, throw the ball down the field, Jameis Winston, that'd be another place where I might look at if I'm Jameis Winston or Andy Reid.
I like the Chiefs. I hadn't thought about the Chiefs before, but Andy Reid may be the one guy who can get Jameis Winston to get away from those boneheaded plays we see from time to time. The Saints, though, you mentioned Teddy Bridgewater. They're going to need a game-day backup to Drew Brees to run the base offense, because when Taysom Hill's the quarterback, it's going to be a completely different offense. He's not a backup to Drew Brees per se. That may be a spot where Winston can kind of reestablish himself, work with Sean Payton, and look at what it did for Teddy Bridgewater, $21 million a year on a three-year deal.
Mike, I'm with you. I know we discussed that a little last week on some of our PFTOT, and it does make a lot of sense. My only question about that would be, at what point do you make Taysom Hill the legit backup and make him a quarterback? I mean, that to me is where I wonder where the Saints are in that. Are they going to continue to run Taysom Hill and do that, even though they're planning on him being the future of the franchise? To me, they're starting to get into the risky territory of that, and they need to start molding him into a full-time quarterback. But everything else you said, Mike, I agree with you. I mean, it makes a lot of sense that way.
And still no 100% guarantee he's even going to be on the team this year. He's a restricted free agent with a first-round tender. Somebody could, in theory, and we usually see it after that first wave of free agency dies down, somebody could swoop in with maybe a low first-round pick and try to make him their guy now, although there currently aren't many spots available. I think anybody who would want him would want to pay him a lot more than $4.6 million to do what he's doing in New Orleans, Chris.
Yeah, I would think so. But this Jameis Winston thing is going to be very interesting. 49ers, did they take a chance to have a backup Jimmy Garoppolo?
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.